Hey everyone, Julian here from IDD, and I'm here with the CEO and president of Phrozen, Ray. Welcome.
Hello everyone. This is Ray from Phrozen.
So Phrozen has been a massive success story in the world of 3D printers. They've committed heavily to the LCD technology and has seen a big fan base and a lot of people starting using them in dentistry. Tell us about your growth and why you chose LCD as your base technology.
Actually, in the past, we start from DLP printers. At that time, actually, we think DLP could be the end solution for the SL Resin 3D printers. But soon in end of 2016, we found LCD. Some printers are constructed by LCD, and we dive into study the technology, and we found there are a lot of space for LCD. The only thing we need to do is to optimize the optical part in the LCD itself, so that it can make this printing technology catch up with DLP and laser 3D printers. So that's why we dive into this industry since 2017. And then in 2018, actually, we do a critical decision. That is, we invest into develop ourselves LCD. Nowadays, we call it mono LCD. It can largely improve the lifetime of the LCD itself and also improve the printing speed of the LCD 3D printers. And with this mono LCD, actually, we can catch up with each resin 3D printing technology like DLP and laser. So it makes LCD 3D printers not like a toy. You could become a professional 3D printers.
Yeah, absolutely. I think when we were talking earlier, it was the mono LCD has a lot longer lifespan because it's just switching from white to black instead of the RGB.
Mono LCD itself is only have a white and black, 0 and 1. And we take off all other noises in these components to make the components has a very quick high efficiency in terms of the optical engine, optical part. Yeah.
Does that help with the cooling as well and keeping the LCD cool?
Actually, it helps. We also considering the heat dissipation in our LCD. So in the past, people always say, oh, my LCD is dead. That is because of the heat. But for us, we increase the top glasses and also the heat design, so that the LCD lifetime can improve up to 5,000 hours.
Yeah. Yeah, really good. That's, I guess, some of the more founding work you've done in the LCD panel industry for 3D printers. So tell me about the history of when you started to do more work in the dental industry and transition from just a resin printer, consumer printer.
Well, at the beginning, we are focusing more on the hobbyist market and also jewelry market. At that time, jewelry is our top priority. So we try to make printed parts as fine as possible and also as accurate as possible because of industrial requirement. But back in 2019, actually, I got lots of requests from IDS, from the IDS show. And lots of people say, oh, I need a very accurate 3D printers. Those people test our printers and found, wow, your printer is so accurate. Also, it's a toy, but it can print very good results, very accurate, and also your design is solid. So many people give us an opportunity to test with them about the digital dentistry's workflow. And then we are qualified by lots of dentists. Then at that time, we realized that, oh, maybe we need to look into the dental industry more and see if what we can do to for this industry. That's why we start our business in dental part. That's back in 2019. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's been a whirlwind ride. Today, how many resins do you have validated for your printer?
I think we have validated with our printers for, I think it's about more than 40 resins with our printers, including some resins from United States, Europe, and also from Asia. Yeah. We mainly focusing on a surgical guide, temporary crown resins, and also some model resins because of the orthodontics request. Yeah.
I hear that you're coming out with a new printer later in the year.
Yeah. In the middle of the 2023, actually, we will get our next generation LCD resin 3D printers. It takes us 1 year to collect all of our users' requirements. And people always say, I want to print a dental model within 10 minutes. Yeah, that's how we start. We try to build a high-speed LCD resin printers that can finish all of your jobs within 30 minutes, including from dental models to every in-mouth applications. That's our major target. Yeah.
That'll be exciting. And I can see you've got what looks like some early prototypes of curing and wash units.
Yes, for dental, 3D printing is only one of the process. We still need washing carefully following the FDS process and also cure it completely to make it in-mouth application to be safe enough. So now got our Perk wash, which has a two-station wash and automatic setup with different OT resins we validated. And also we got a curing units that can cure the parts. It has a heating function and you can put the nitrogens during the curing so that you can cure your parts completely. So that's our post-process units, ProCure and ProWash. It will be announced in middle of May. Yeah.
They're planned to come out with the next generation printer?
Yes, it will come out with the next generation printer. After all, we hope we can provide a total solution to all our customers, not only the printer itself. Yeah.
Exciting times. And is there any news on the software front? You've got some great easy-to-use software. Is there any developments there?
Yeah, we also put a lot of efforts in our software development, especially on Slicer. We try to customize, or we try to optimize the way we added support and the way we handle the raw data from intraoral scanner. So integration with the scanner and the scanner software and designing software is our key goals in our Slicer development. And also we are adding some cloud functions to let you back up and update your resin profile at a timely manner. So that got an updated profile from time to time. Yeah.
Great. So it'll save having to manually download them and install them. Nice. I see you've got a Medit scanner here as well. Is there a special integration with Medit scanners or it doesn't change no matter what scanner?
We have integrated with Medit officially, and so it can go with the Medit app and also Medit's designing software. So the total workflow is highly integrated. You can directly transfer your file from Medit scanner to our Slicer for sure without any problem.
Okay, so have a look in your Medit box inside Medit Link, and you'll be able to find the Phrozen app.
Yeah, sure. Our first time to join these big shows, and we hope more and more people can know us, not only from consumer end, but from the dental end. We want to deliver all of our R&D results and also our product benefits for our partners and also the end users. See you in IDS 2023. We are in the 11.3. Welcome to join us.
All right. Thanks, guys. And look out for another IDD update on YouTube.